Hi everyone, I'm Fabian Ecker, one of the designers of Swords and Soldiers. Today I want to show you how the online multiplayer works. The online multiplayer is one of the key features of the game, and therefore we integrated it in a very special way. You can access the multiplayer through the main menu. Here you can choose your preferred faction and color. Once you're ready, you can start searching for an opponent by pressing the search button. The spinning globe shows that I'm online and searching for opponents. This is the cool part. After I started the search, I can just move to any other part of the game and start playing some single player content. So yesterday I've played some Viking levels, and I will continue with that while in the background the game will keep searching for online opponents. So here I am, at level 3 of the Vikings. The goal of this specific level is to reach the end of the level with any kind of unit. I can choose between two paths. One on the top, which is heavily guarded by towers, but the troops can find a lot of crates, filled with gold. Or I can choose to take the lower cliff passage, which is not very well guarded, but has less crates. So let's start by upgrading the berserkers and the lightning spell. Let's take the lower cliff passage. I will have to destroy this first tower, but my berserkers will get slaughtered by this axe thrower. So let's shoot a guy out of the tower with some lightning. Let's keep building berserkers. Ah, the game has found an opponent. The game will now save this exact state, so I can return after the online game. Let's get ready for battle. As you can see, I had chosen the Chinese and will face the Vikings. I'm going to try to do a rush tactic. Let's upgrade some monkey ninjas and try to get an early score by getting my units out there as soon as possible.
Upgrade ready!
I'm lucky he's building berserkers. Berserkers are melee units, and monkeys will just stun them and damage them. Oh no, he's countering my attack with axe throwers. I have to change my strategy. Let's go for swordsmen. Swordsmen are very good against ranged units. Let's also upgrade the arrow rain to destroy large numbers of units at the same time. Let's kill his workers with an arrow rain. Ha, I'm destroying his base. Nice, I've won the game and I went up a rank. Now I can play a rematch against the same opponent or quit, which I will do, and now you can see I returned to my previous campaign level just where I left off. So this way you'll never have to wait in the menu for an online game, you can just go ahead and play any kind of single player mode like a campaign or the different challenges, whatever you like. Within the level you can also access the online menu to start searching or quit searching if you just want to play offline. Swords and Soldiers will be released in a few weeks on PSN and PC, featuring this very cool online multiplayer. If you're looking for updates and news on the Swords and Soldiers game, just follow us on Twitter and Facebook. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching.